I think these are two very well-weighted teams.
Let's go. I hear the engines. Pepsi Cola is there. Quick Flow is there. Overlay is up and off we go. Quick Flow in a very cool looking Dominus. Always has a nice looking car, just Quick Flow. It's a nice looking vehicle. It's got some cute little ears on the top. Pepsi Cola coming in for the first attack. Well kept out by Quick Flow. I've not seen Pepsi Cola play a lot, Breezy. I don't know if you've tuned in much to Pepsi Cola and seen, oh, Quick Flow's missed out, hit the post and come out.
I've seen very little, to be honest, so I don't really have a lot to go off. It will be interesting. Obviously, Quick Flow seen plenty of in the last chapter. One of my most improved players for last chapter, by a long margin, actually.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more with that. Came a long way. I think a lot of that team energy came through with Quick Flow last chapter. They had a great time. Quick Flow performed very well. They all performed really well last chapter. We talked about STEM already. Pepsi's going to get the first goal here. Quick Flow missed out early, hit the post, it came out. But it's Pepsi Cola in her first appearance here, who scores first.
I like Quick Flow may have just had a freebie with the demolition, but unfortunately not.
Interesting to see how the players work each other out here. Quick Flow posted in the Discord earlier in the week that he can't get past the high platinums, I think, in ones. I think he's a far better player than that.
Pretty sure he was pushing. Was he pushing C2 in? There you go. Pushing C2 in twos. No, C3. Potentially C3. C2, C3.
That's a really good play as well. Waits for Pepsi Cola to commit. Pepsi Cola comes out wide. Quick Flow. The net available. Gets a nice shot on target. I do like the look of that Dominus that Quick Flow has equipped. Nope.
It's got the old BDS decal on. Represent.
There you go. BDS finally doing some good, I think, weren't they? Said, last night. Finally won a couple of games.
I'll be honest with you, I am very sinful for not paying attention to RLCS for the most part.
Yeah, I think they went 2-1 in their group. Finished second overall, I think, from memory. Could be wrong there. Certainly better than recent performances when they dropped down to the qualifiers, I think, to actually make the major this time. Pepsi with a soft touch. Low boost. Misses out a couple of times. Bates Quick Flow in, though. Pepsi's going to survive this one for the time being. Collects the mid. Quick Flow takes the corner. It's going to be Quick Flow's play. Well done. Gets over the top again. Pepsi Cola goes for the challenge, but Quick Flow was there first. It's a really nice first touch inboard from Quick Flow. Pepsi Cola was never going to get there in time. Well done. Well finished from Quick Flow. Finds his second. Takes the lead. 2,000 points. Well, that would be far less interesting than Breezy shaving all of the hair on his head. Lux. That's what we should be pushing for here.
There's a way around it that I've considered that is a little less permanent.
Fighter, how are you, mate? Trying to be like you with the beard? Yeah. Bearded RZA.
Bearded RZA.
I never usually get to this stage. It usually gets way too itchy before it gets to this stage, but managed to somehow bypass that this time. That's why it looks the way it does. Quick Flow double! Gee, it looked unlikely for a while. I thought he might have pinched it out off the crossbar there for a while. He hit the ball pretty much on the crossbar, but does find a way to bring it down. Quick Flow finds his third, and it's his third in a row. It was Pepsi who scored first.
Yeah, it was a little bit... I thought the very last touch that he got was unnecessary, potentially. I thought it might have taken it just over.
Takes a dive off the wall. Pepsi also on the wall there. Quick Flow is not going to be able to finish this one off right away. Pepsi gets the boost, gets the ball touch out. Going to have one chance to score this before Quick Flow gets back and gets a soft touch, but it's enough. And Quick Flow can't make it back in time. Well done by Pepsi.
A very nervous touch, but successful nevertheless.
She did really well. She washed off a lot of her speed before she got to the ball. It's so tempting just to try and hit that first time. Does well, gets herself back in the game. Only a goal separating the two players now. It's a close encounter. Very evenly matched players. Quick Flow with a touch straight into Pepsi. Pepsi finds herself in a pretty dangerous position now in the corner. Can she get a bump? No, Quick Flow gets a touch over the top and Quick Flow will walk it in. It's always dangerous when you find yourself on your opponent's back wall in the corner. You need to affect the play. Doesn't get a touch on Quick Flow, and Quick Flow scores his fourth. Yeah, I very rarely clean shave. I look like the youngest 35-year-old on the planet when I do. Try and avoid that as much as I can. Not a great recovery from quick play.
Most people would absolutely kill for that.
Well done by Beps. She gets a nice little cut in board there. Quick flow with a really poor recovery. Well done by Beps to push it behind quick flow. He was in all sorts of trouble from that first touch from Beps, and good finish as well. Finds her third, closes the gap again.
Yeah, you can feel the nerves, can't you? And even though there's a lot of nervous touches going around, Beps has just completely dusted this kickoff.
It's the first kickoff goal we've seen. It's always nervous, obviously, being first up in the ones, but also when you find yourself in a really even matchup like this as well.
Quick flow was just off on his roof and in no man's land. I've never liked the dominus in ones kickoffs, to be honest.
And what happened to quick flow there? I'm not sure if that was an intentional delayed kickoff from quick flow, if he just made a mistake. But Pepsi Cola has her second kickoff goal in three and has taken the lead back. It was only moments ago quick flow had a 2-goal lead. It was quite a low scoring encounter for the first 2 or 3 minutes. It's opened up here, and Bepsi, the beneficiary, 5 goals on the board. Quick flow hitting the ball hard, but it's to his disadvantage, really. Where's Bepsi on this? Bepsi pushing, fake challenge. Well done by Beps. Should be able to clear this one out wide, but only as far as quick flow gets a touch. It's going to bounce awkwardly off the corner. Misses out on the touch. Beps is there. And they race back. Quick flow does well enough to keep control of the ball. Still 90 seconds remaining. No need to panic on the play yet, Breezy.
Yeah, do you know, I'm not sure whether that missed kickoff was an attempt at a speed flip. It looked like a speed flip fail to me. Don't know whether he's been working on that in his spare time.
Yeah, a dangerous time to pull out a mechanic that you may not be super comfortable with. It's cost him the lead here. Pepsi lining up down the wing. Good challenge from Quick Flow. Really low risk challenge as well. Pepsi really needed to get behind that ball and absorb more of the challenge. Ends up driving a little bit off center right as Quick Flow challenged, and anything there was going to be huge for Quick Flow. We're all square, less than a minute remaining. This is a tight contest.
It is indeed, yeah. Especially with the 50s as well. I feel like you have such an advantage in 50s in the Octane versus the Dominus. I hate the Dominus for kickoffs and 50s. I despise them. I feel like it's something that doesn't do that particular thing very well. Could just be me, of course.
Pepsi doing well here. Oh, I thought the cut was on. Couldn't quite control the ball. It's in a dangerous spot for Quick Flow. Quick Flow goes here. He's going to be overcommitted. It's a touch into the back wall. It's a good result. And there he goes into the net. Can Peps bring it around? Quick Flow is coming. He's not going to get there in time. And again, he's outraced towards his own net. It was always dangerous. He was lining up, and any kind of attempt on goal was going to force him towards Pepsi's back wall. He ended up missing out. And Bepsi walks it downfield. Dementor Man, how are you? Welcome.
Yeah, I think the big difference there is, you know, the players that are confident with the flicks can flick earlier, so there's no immediate danger of going into the backboard, but he's brought it back early doors again.
Everyone in the chat's a mod. That's very true.
Trading blows these two.
Yes, Quick Flow fires back with a kickoff goal of his own. 6 apiece. Nothing separating him. Can we go to OT in game number 1? It has been a real even arm wrestle, this one. Really tight contest between these two players. Beps with the kickoff win here. 12 seconds to make something work. Oh, edgeable bump! Great setup from Bepsi.
You love to see it. I knew you were going to be all over this.
Oh, it was an unsavable attempt. Quick Flow could have possibly been up quicker there. Might have had the touch if he had been higher as the ball crossed the line. But it was a really dangerous setup from Beps. Whatever happened there, Quick Flow was always going to be in trouble as a result. You love to see it. If you can get that setup, Breezy, you can do so much damage against any opponent. Now that's going to be on target. That's... Oh! Yeah.
Oh. Nearly by 2 goals. For those of you who are not aware, Riz probably had a tear in his eye during that moment.
Oh, I keep pressing the wrong buttons. There we go. I finally got the right button. Absolutely. Bepsi Cola takes game number 1. I think I've got it set to automatically do it. You can do it for me if you don't mind. I don't know how to even navigate the menu to save it these days. You used to just be able to press Y and it would do it. Oh no, wait, it's left stick.
Fresh meat.
Yes, it's clicking the left stick.
Inspiring check. Welcome. One. So let's just call it that. I have got it set to automatically upload, but I don't trust it. Oh, thank you, Lux, for deleting whatever that was. I didn't even get to see it. Congratulations.
Another one. To... It was if we wanted bots for the channel.
Do we want what? Bots?
Do we want bots for the channel?
Oh, no. We can do without bots. Thank you, though. I appreciate the sentiment. Well done by Beps. First game on stream takes down Quickflow in the first of this best of three. Really good performance. Obviously, going to be a lot of nerves. Handled them very well. Wouldn't be surprised to see Quickflow take this one back and send it to three, though. Played really well. Just a few mistakes and a few close calls there. The race is back to goal. Both were in favour of Pepsi Cola, and Quickflow was right on her heels both times. We'll see how well Quickflow adapts to the 1v1 arena here. There's a good chance first up. It's a nice high pop, but I don't know what he's got in mind to try and get that into the goal. Bepsy's there, and a poor landing. Bepsy's also got an awkward one to try and convert. Just pushes it on target. Quickflow goes for the boost. Doesn't pay the price. Quickflow tries to shoot it on target, but sends it wide. Beps takes a nice wide route to goal. We'll swap this one back out. Quickflow again has the ball, but it's an awkward one to convert from. Can you do as well to send it into the corner? There's Beps diving in over the top. Well done. Has a shot on target. Quickflow won't get there again. And the first 30 seconds belong to Quickflow, but the first goal will go to Beps.
Yeah, I think he seems to have more of the overall pressure in the game, just not converting the way he would be hoping at the moment.
Quickflow is going to take ball and boost here. Pepsi tries to make it a little bit awkward, but has paid the ultimate price as a result. Gets into the line of fire.
Yeah, you love to see it. That was the perfect. That was the one's punish right there. Do not ever cut across my line, my pathing, is the word.
Yeah, I'm sure Nob's in their call right now, giving pats on the back to Quicklow for that one. And then another kickoff goal. Pepsi Cola has had the advantage in the kickoffs. That's her third kickoff goal. Really well positioned for that one. Just absorbed everything that Quickflow threw at her there. I'm starting to see things open up, Breezy. It was such a tight encounter through the first 3 minutes of game number one. There was hardly any goals on the board. There might have been four between the players. But there is a flurry of goals. That's a really strange boost grab there. Well done from Quickflow just to get in the way. Games by Dan with the resub. 22 months. Oh, my God. Welcome, though. Quickflow coming in. We're starting off a new chapter of crew battles, mate. Probably didn't even realize the old ones had finished. This is so long between visits. But welcome, and thank you for the 22 months. Probably the longest standing sub streak we have in this channel. Bepsy can't get it past Quickflow. It's an awkward bounce for both players. What's Quickflow got for us here? Bepsy and Quickflow both go. They both miss. They both fake each other out, and it's effective from both ends of the field. Oh, Quickflow doesn't shoot. Waits down. Bit of panic from both players here. Plenty of time for Beps to get that corner boost like she originally planned. Quickflow just puts it into the sidewall. There's a bit of C ball, hit ball action going on here, Breezy. Both players are a little bit nervous. Quickflow with a controlling touch, cutting it inboard. Oh, lovely flick over the top.
Yeah, a lot riding on this game. Like you say, both teams, likewise, you could be playing for a loss at the end, but both teams will be wanting to get off to the best start.
Yeah, well, they're fighting it out. This is a real battle, this one. Every single series is so important as well. This is such an even matchup between these two players, but it'll be so telling for the matchup as a whole for the player that does take it. Quickflow with a good shot. Pepsi Cola gets up this time. And gets in the way. Both players up at the same time again. I think Beps has missed. Is it on target? Has it missed? It's on target. We had a weird angle to look at. It was on target, though. Beps knew all about it. You can almost tell from her car body language. Is car body language a thing? I'm going to say it is.
I can't correct you, so no, it's sure.
Beps takes the lead. Another kickoff from Beps. It should be a goal. No, he doesn't have any boost left in the tank to accelerate through the ball. And then gives the ball straight to Quickflow, who's probably got a little bit up his sleeve. No, he's got none as well to accelerate. We see them trade the exact same blows. Neither player has boosts when the finish is required, and they both back away. Big clear from Beps. Will alleviate the pressure for the time being. Both players have plenty of boosts. And again, the ball hangs high. It's Quickflow that's up and manages to somehow get a demo on Beps, but it's not going to work out too bad for Beps. Quickflow with the ball in an awkward position on the sidewall here. Beps has spawned back. Again, we see Beps go wide. She's taken these challenges really wide. She pays the price more often than not for doing so, but takes Quickflow out of the equation for this one.
Yeah, definitely returning the favour there. close, had the most of the demos, but too slow on that ball.
Yeah, it just wasn't the touch that Beps was after, was it? The ball just went so high and had no boost to get up for it, had no boost to recover with, just had to watch it happen in the end.
Yeah, coming over her shoulder, whereas Quickflow would have had full view of that from the moment she touched it.
Is chat on mod only? It's literally every single person is a mod in the chat. It's
very strange. How Jesus?
Yeah, many by the looks of it. I honestly, if you had have asked me before the stream, I would have said maybe five, but it turns out the whole community is a mod. Oh, that doesn't take them. That doesn't take Beps out. Oh, chance for Beps. Quickflow panics across the goal line. Beps has no boost though. Turns as well. Dangerous. Good 50 though. Will allow her to get boosts. Has to shadow for the time being. Quickflow looks dangerous here. Has good control. Gets it over the top, but can't quite bring it around. And Bepsy can't bring it around either. And Quickflow will turn and shoot. And that's not going to be a goal either. Yes, it is. They finally find the back of the net.
Oh, dear. Series of unfortunate events.
Quickflow, all he had to do was just accelerate into the ball. He went for the flick. It almost cost him the goal. Beps almost got back. It was a very strange play. Quickflow now has the lead. And this is where it's been dangerous for him, the kickoff, but he does this one well. He's got the ball and the boost. Bepsy Cola's going to have to retreat to the corner. Good control again from Quickflow. It's a nice flick, but it's well wide. Going to take the corner. Quickflow obviously didn't get it. Bepsy obviously didn't get it. Quickflow has a huge advantage on the play now. We'll get that corner as well. Bepsy has none. Interesting play. Bepsy's got one pad. That boost has been taken as well by Quickflow. Bepsy's hanging around. It's dangerous to do so. Quickflow should score here. Bepsy either needed to back off or go. She ended up doing neither. Got caught out in no man's land. And Quickflow takes full advantage. Opens up the lead to two. Probably the biggest lead we've seen Quickflow have for some time. And are we heading to game number three, Breezy?
I reckon we are. I think with that play, I didn't mind Beps actually staying with it, but she took a really wide turn for the turn. She got beaten, and when with no boost, you want to be staying as close as you can to the ball.
36 seconds left.
To back off.
Oh, I thought Beps was going to get a goal there. Well done by Quickflow. Stamps it out. Can't bring that one around, though. Had all the time in the world in the end, but didn't make the most of it. That's going to go high off the bar and out as well. Bepsy's still not out of this contest, telegraphing from a mile away that she has no boost. Quickflow again. Finds the ball into the back wall, into the net now. Bepsy Cola. The opportunities keep coming up, but she has no boost. She's finally taken the corner. 10 seconds left. A goal and a kickoff goal will be handy. Quickflow gets back, and Quickflow will stamp this out. And that'll be the second game in favor of Quickflow. Pillow Fight will strike back, and they will take the 1-3. Well done by Quickflow. Very even contest still.
Yeah, well fought back. Definitely been a good show between the two of them. He did a little more to adjust. He got a couple of the early demos at the start. Again, though, I think he had a lot more shots and a lot less luck with his shots and his touches. Yeah, I'm not wrong.
Beps, anyway, thanks for the follow. While you're playing as well, I hope you're not listening to the stream while you're doing it. I don't know how people do that. There are people that do.
Yes, Dementor, you lunatic.
Had to give him one game. There you go. No, it's a great contest. We're thoroughly enjoying it. Game number three, first up here. I think this would be a really good series, Breezy. I think the matchups are pretty even across the board. I was going to mention earlier, I haven't really seen Chubbo play much. I think we've got Schmeevil stepping in for Jack, who I also haven't seen. But you have seen Chubbo play, I believe. Would you rate him as a GC1 sort of area player?
High GC1.
High GC1. There you go. We are waiting for the Breeze to ready up. No, I'm okay, Rizzo. Miss B, sorry. I'm okay, Miss B. Thank you. I have a beer.
Yes. When I played with him, he was rather speedy around the field, and he had a really good single reset shot in him.
Interesting to see.
His single resets were very, very consistent.
Interesting to see if he can get some of that on show for us in the twos and threes. Straight after this, we're one apiece here. Bepsy Cola versus Quickflow. It's Pillow Fight versus Ball Bust and Booties opening up their season with a third game straight up. And Bepsy Cola has made it look awkward, but has found the back of the net regardless. Another kickoff win. All the time in the world there. You can see Quickflow was just gone from that play. See you later. Bep says, thank you very much. That's how you want to start a game number three. Settle those nerves nice and early. See both players just doing the the very vanilla drive up and flip into the ball. Oh, what a shot!
Oh, bends.
What a shot from Quickflow. No boosts. Collects one pad, picks the ball up on the Dominus, the low to the ground Dominus, and flicks it immediately in the top right. Outstanding finish from Quickflow and strikes back. First 10 seconds has been entertaining already. Should be a good final game between these two. Who's your money on, Breezy? I usually ask that in the game number 3. What do you reckon?
It's very difficult. They're playing two very different games. Bepsy's been very calm and been happy to absorb the pressure from Quickflow. Quickflow has definitely been the more pressing player, but has also been punished for overcommitting a few times. Oh, tough call. I reckon Quickflow, but only if he is getting his shots on target the way that he is now.
Yeah, I think that Quickflow is playing a very aggressive game of ones here, which I think will work as long as Bepsy does not counter it well. And we haven't seen Bepsy counter it that well so far in game number 3 here. She needs to play a far more patient game, I think. But Quickflow keeps doing this. He keeps finding himself on the back wall. And how many goals?
The easy stuff.
How many goals have we seen from Bepsy Cola where she has just walked the ball all the way down the field with a Quickflow in pursuit?
She's definitely, this is what I mean about Quickflow. He's being more aggressive, but he's also putting himself into more awkward positions, and Bepsy is being good enough to be patient enough to just let him do things like this. And shot's gone wide, but she should probably still score it.
She does well, and you're right, you're exactly right. Quickflow is playing so aggressively, and sort of what I was saying as well. Just needs to hold her nerve, absorb the challenges, throw a few fake challenges in maybe. And don't try and meet Quickflow in the air. Maybe stay grounded and just take that ball away. Quickflow, whenever he shoots, he finds himself on the back wall. Bepsy has scored so many goals as a result from it already. And there you see Bepsy. She comes close, but she dives away quickly. Quickflow eliminates her from the play, but it'll be on the back wall of Quickflow for the time being. Topsy-turvy contest early in game number 3.
Apparently, Dementa says she was very nervous coming into this, as a lot of people are, especially the first time. Maybe used to streaming in front of her own crowd, but playing in a tournament setting with other people reliant on you can be very daunting.
Yeah, I agree. It's probably not playing in front of the crowd that bothers her so much. It would be the pressure for the team. It's not very often you play this as a team sport that actually means something the way it does here. Competitive Rocket League is sort of whatever. You lose your queue again. Doesn't really matter. This is a little bit different, and she's doing very well. She finds her 4. She's playing a really smart game. She's adapted to this playstyle from Quickflow, and Quickflow does make good contact there, but very ineffective contact.
Yeah, she's waiting down very well. This is the game plan from Bepsy that I said will beat Quickflow unless Quickflow can get the majority of his shots on target that he's in his aggression.
Oh, well done by Quickflow to get back. Bepsy trying to recover off the in-out. Not so much a save, but the in-out, whatever you call it when it's not a save. Here comes Quickflow. He looks to cut it. Can get it around. It's in the... Oh, what a shot in the end from Quickflow.
How has he managed to get that in?
Surely he has the calculated quick chat. You drop it 3 times there. Manages to scoop the ball off the back wall and walk it in. I'm not sure that can be repeated easily. What a way to strike back from Quickflow when he needed a goal. He found a miracle and he's closed the gap to 1. And he's flipped away from this one. Mid boost
that
belongs to Bepsy. The ice cream scooper says Chubsy. Yeah, it's very interesting. Very interesting.
That was not going in if he didn't do that. He was hitting the side, I'm pretty confident.
It was the only way it was going in. He was going to be on the back wall as a result if he didn't. Ended up working out very nicely for him. Another big shot downfield, and it's helped on its way from Bepsy. Unfortunate. I'm not sure it was really going to be on target, was it? Let's have a look at it again. I'm sure Bepsy doesn't want to see it again. It's difficult to see from this angle that we get, but it was going to be touch and go.
Maybe, but it didn't have much pace to it. I think she just felt that it just, like you say, those pressure moments where you just feel like you have to jump for something, and then afterwards you think to yourself, why did I do that? The pressure of the moment.
Sorry, I've got a stray kid in the room. Just shoot her on her way.
Oh, they're the worst.
Oh, well, lovely 50 from Beps. and it's in off the post. They're not coming easy at the moment, are they? They're having to find something a little bit different in game number three here. Really well done from Beps. That's outstanding ball control. A bit of left and right on that. The challenge comes in from Quick Flow, but it's a 50 straight into the back of his own net.
Yeah, big fan of that though. Like a game mode, a competitive game like this where they've really got to grind it out. They've got to work for the goals. They're not coming freely.
Quick Flow again, a goal down. That was a good opportunity there. He realized that corner was free. And Bepsy probably wasn't getting to it. Ends up eliminating Beps and scores. Anyway, they're locked up at 5 apiece, and it's the contest we were after in game number 3. It tells the story of the contest so far through the first 3 games. It has been tight all the way through. Two, like you say, Breezy, very different play styles meeting head-to-head and finding some kind of strange balance between them. Bepsy, another kickoff win here. Remy, how are you, mate?
Pushed out by Beps off Quick Flow though.
Gary. Good ball control from Quick Flow. Gets the flick away, but oh, that's not a great result. Bepsy's going to try and cut it. Can she walk it down the field again? No, Quick Flow's going to get back this time. Couldn't quite get the control and didn't have the boost to accelerate through it either. Flow, another nice little flick. You can see why he's equipped the Dominus for this. He's very handy with the flicks, the early catch and grab. Bepsy has no boost, but Quick Flow is not in the equation, and Bepsy takes the lead. Good challenge in the midfield from Beps as Quick Flow loses control of the carry and holds on to a one goal lead.
Just not quite getting the catch on the top of his car before his flicks, is he? I think the flip there was a panic flip when he realized that he didn't have the catch.
Yeah, well, if they were nervous at the start, they're going to be even more nervous now. There's almost nothing separating them. And Quick Flow with a very ambitious air dribble. Bepsy Cola catches it. How much boost has Beps got? Has she got enough? She loses control. Quick Flow, the window opens, and Quick Flow takes his opportunity. Still a goal behind, though. Beps stops in the midfield. Quick Flow has nothing. Needs to collect a big boost here and counter-attack at some stage. What's Beps got? This is a really awkward ball for Quick Flow. Does not look comfortable. That's an outstanding catch, though. Cuts, shoots, goal for Quick Flow. Unfortunate for Beps. She sat there for the longest time wondering what was going to happen. In the end, the time to challenge was not there. Goes diving past. Solstice, how are you, mate?
Oh, who's going to win this? I keep thinking that Quick Flow is going to capitulate and give it away, and then he finds another goal out of something.
It's just one of those matchups, isn't it? You've got the mech player, the player with the mech, which is Quick Flow, up against the brains of Beps and defense. And if the mech works, it's difficult to stop. There is Quick Flow, does get the carry and the catch and sends it up and over Bepsy Cola. Good control from Quick Flow. Gets those nerves in check in the late stage here of game number 3. Another kickoff win for Beps. She's got 9 seconds. She's only going to really get one chance here. It's high. It's straight into Quick Flow. It's going to come out wide. It's going to have to be a mechanical goal to score. It's going to land. It's going to be Quick Flow. Really well played from Quick Flow. A tough, tough series. Manages to get the result for his team. It is Pillow Fight who take the ones. What a series it was. It was outstanding, wasn't it, Breezy? Really entertaining series between the two players.
Literally, I was on the edge, but I think that has properly set us up, because my prediction is I think that Ball Bustin are winning the twos, most likely, in my opinion. Which should take us nicely into the threes, I reckon.
All right, so let's go. We saw a bunch of people leave the lobby there. Maybe we'll go to menu.
They're coming back in by the looks of it. Chubbsy's back in.
They're coming in. Roger that. Twos or... Oh, we're going twos. Yeah, we are going twos. I think that was discussed before, so we were just ready up for some twos. We have hopefully got a Schmeevil in here somewhere. He's in the party, I believe. Might just quickly... Actually, I won't send him an invite straight away. I'll do that a little bit later. I'm sure he's got some nerves going on. He doesn't want to be dealing with a Steam friend request immediately. Get rid of these green dots and we go for a twos contest that could also be very entertaining, Breezy. I think it's going to be 3 entertaining series here. We started off well with the ones.
It's going to be very close. I'm only backing them by a little bit. I reckon that I reckon they've got a stronger average rank, but not by a lot.
Geez, quick flow, well played. Really great series between you two. It was really entertaining. Thanks for the show. Two very different play styles, like we talked about all the way through. We get to see two new players take to the screen. We have Chubsy representing Ball Bust and Booties, and we have Schmeevil filling in for Jack here on Pillow Fight. Oh, it's not! Oh, it's no. Been denied early. A Pillow Fight. Knob and Schmeevil both clean up the crossbar and can't make it work. You see some chasing going on, Stem versus Knob. A little bit of bad blood between the teams. We didn't talk about it earlier, but it was supposed to be Knob, Stem, and Quickflow again. Stem jump ship in favor of Pepsi Cola. And we'll see what comes out. We know Knob loves a good demo. There's been no better time than now. Looks like a high octane game early. Stem walking it through the midfield, takes a cut to gain control, flicks it over the top, but Schmeevil is there. Miss out on the corner boost there. Leaves it for Schmeevil to stamp. Chubsy diving into the back corner and sends Knob packing. There is Schmeevil. Gets a soft touch though. Stem shoots it. Scores. No, it's up the post and out. Neither team can find the opening despite all their best efforts. This is an exciting start to the first game here. Breezy shot wide. Oh, well wide. And Knob sends Stem into the back of the net. Schmeevil cuts it mid. Knob in defense. Slams it out. Schmeevil is there. Should be able to redirect this one on target. Can't. It's wide again. Schmeevil again. It's wide again. And Chubsy should clean it up over the net. It's a soft touch here. It's a really dangerous touch, but collects it. Nobody is pushed. 30 boost to the name. There's Knob diving in. Dunks over the top of Chubsy, looking for the bump on Stem, but Stem avoids it. Punch downfield. Could be the first goal. No, Knob is there to swat it out wide. Stem takes the corner boost away from him. I'm not sure how much Knob has in the tank. Sends it downfield. Stem is there. Schmeevil chasing it down, but Stem will send it all the way to the backboard. Forces Knob into a save. Still nobody able to find the back of the net. It's a great game of Rocket League so far. Stem catches in the midfield. Flicks over the top, but it should be Smeevil's ball. He gets it wide and Knob collects. Tries to make it orphan from Chubsy. You talked about this earlier. The catch and flick on the flip reset executed, but Schmeevil there to meet it. Knob will meet this one. It should be the first one there. The brown goes off. I'm so used to hearing that. Into the corner. Knobbo looks to center it for his teammate. Schmeevil there. Goal. Schmeevil waits down. Bump on his own teammate coming in from Stem. Bit of friendly fire. And you got to say, that cost him there. Great pass from Knob and good finish from Schmeevil.
Nobody's safe on this field, are they?
There is some venom getting around on the pitch at the moment. Chubsy catches.
I think we're in danger of being demoed.
Schmeevil with a soft one. We'll 50 Stem here. It's a good 50, but it should favour Chubsy. No, Knob's going to be the first one there. Chubsy waits back. Knob looking to cause some chaos on the goal line again. Chubsy walks it away. Stem stays back. I'm not sure if he got a bump there from Knob. Gets a bump on Schmeevil on return. Knob with a cut. Going to get a 50 with Stem here. Schmeevil's going to be required. 65 boost in the tank and sees Chubsy going for the mid. The net should be open momentarily. Gets a poor first touch though. And he's met by Stem. Stem looking to send this crossfield. Chubsy is there. Knob is back. They're playing a smart game of Rocket League Pillow Fight. It's high octane and Ball Bust and Booties are playing well. But the defensive rotations from Pillow Fight are very strong. It's going to be very hard to get the ball into the back of the net. Well, welcome Choco Potato. How are you, mate? Schmeevil is actually Jack. Yeah, that's right, yes. I could have probably done a little overlay change for that. Touch from Schmeevil, not the best, but it favours Knob in the end. Knob's going to dive in for the dunk. Almost gets it over the top of Chubsy. Chubsy with a chance now. A bit of mech on show. Doesn't get the first touch right. Stem with the angle. Chubsy, he's missed out. And they've been denied again. They've had so many good chances. Knob's going to collect the mid, push it into the corner. It's going to be an awkward bounce for Stem, who does well to get around it. Into the back corner for Schmeevil. Doesn't take the back corner boost. He might have left that four Knob. If he did, that's the right play. There's Schmeevil pushing it inboard, but only as far as Stem. Knob's going to need to make a good save here. Chubsy's there threatening as well. It's only as far as Stem. Stem shoots goals!
It's a long time coming, wasn't it? Jesus.
Gee, Knob almost there again. You see him bounce off the back wall here. Almost in the position to make the save. Couldn't quite affect it. Well done from Stem. Stays in a really good position to affect the angle. One apiece. There's less than a minute of Rocket League left, and who is going to win this one? This is an even contest as well. this one could very well go the distance as well, and I hope it does. It's an entertaining contest between these two players. Smeevil pushes it wide. Chubsy with a pre-flip misses out as well. Stem with an awkward challenge in the corner of the field. It's a 2v1. Smeevil looking for Nob, but Nob wasn't there. The ball ends up favouring Chubsy. And he pushes it into the corner of the field. Smeevil does well to alleviate the pressure, though, after the demo on Nob. Back in the midfield, Nob is there. It's a goal! The demo on Stem came from Smeevil. Chubsy took out Smeevil, but it left Nob in the centre all on his own.
Yeah, I think he had to give that ball up there in the corner. After that, he was like, he had to recognise that Chubbs wasn't quite back. And giving the ball up would have meant that he could have kept a handle on the situation.
Hopefully Breezy is a bit louder now. Thank you for letting me know.
No love lost whatsoever.
They've got their lead back to pillow fight. There was only even Stevens for a short time there. Chubsy and Stem will need to find something here, but they're in an awkward position. It's going to be a goal. Nob's too good to miss out on that opportunity. 3-1 in favour of pillow fight, and they have taken the ones, and they are going to hold an advantage in the twos as well.
Yeah, they've played very well so far. They've I think they rode the pressure really well. What I predicted at the very start of this game came to pass. They had all the pressure, but Pillow Fight were defending so well at the same time.
Breezy's prediction is looking a bit iffy. Yes, it is looking a little bit iffy.
It is. I'm happy to be wrong if it is a case that they defended so well that the pressure didn't come through. Like they have nine saves to Ball Bustin's one.
Look at the points differential as well. 727, 651. The highest for Ball Bustin was 348 for Stem. Huge performance. 9 saves on Pillow Fight, Breezy. I think you just touched on that. Really good performance from Pillow Fight. I think Chubsy looked a little bit nervous. A little bit nervous for me. You can tell he's a very talented player. We'll see how he settles in through game number 2 here. If they don't settle into game number 2, Breezy, it'll be all too late. And we will head to the threes with a dead rubber.
They definitely came out firing. They stated their intentions early, having the majority of the demos and the pressure in the first, what, minute, 2 minutes of that game. They were all over them.
Stem commits there on the kickoff. Yeah, it should be a goal immediately. Nob's not going to miss out here. Started to take to the air. Looked like he went up fairly slow as well. Was beaten out by Smeevil comfortably there. Left huge gap between the player and the net as well. Came in from the angle. It's never really going to affect the play there, and Chubsy, after taking the kickoff, is never going to get back in time. It's an early goal in favour of Pillow Fight. It's not what you want to see if you're rooting for the Ball Bust and Booties.
Yeah, it was another one of those scenarios. Stem repeated his mistake at the end of the last game. He decided to go for a ball instead of just letting it go.
Nob with a bit of demo work on Chubsy downfield. Stem can only push that as far as Nob, and who gives it straight back? Chubsy should be there. Touches at mid, but Schmeevil's going to be the first one there. Good dunk from Chubsy. Where is Stem on the play? The ball bounces a little bit awkwardly. I think it caught Stem out there. Might have been a little bit too close to the goal to make use of that bounce. Here comes Schmeevil. Nob just looking for the chaos ball. Pool shots everyone into it. Ends up in the corner. Chubsy and Stem are both fighting over it. Stem decides to back off, and Chubsy sends it downfield. And Nob just says, get out of here. Can't stay stationary for that long around here. Schmeevil into the back wall. Can he get a centering ball? Stem is there first. I'm not sure he's going to beat Nob out here, though. There's a 50 in the corner. Schmeevil up. Chubsy's going to have to back off. Does well. Collects the ball. Collects the boost. Gets a bump from Schmeevil. Schmeevil takes it away from Nob, and that's going to be a goal, surely. Openest of nets for Chubsy. Schmeevil got the good first touch back towards Nob here and then took the ball away from him.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think they just need to the ball busters, ball busting, just need to settle the nerves. They're looking like a very nervous duo at the moment, stepping on each other's toes a little bit.
I think you're 100% right. They don't have long to figure it out. They have drawn back here from a big mistake from Schmeevil and Nob. Upfield, here comes Chubsy with some mech. There's nothing that gets you back into the groove of things like a good, well-executed bit of mech, Breezy. Not that I know anything about that. Schmeevil straight into Stem. That's a good bounce for Stem. Well done by Nob. Where's Chubsy on the play? Stays down, and that's going to favour Schmeevil. Chubsy ends up not going, but overcommitting. Stem just slams it off his own post. I wasn't too sure about it. He knew all about it. Oh, the dunk from the Nob is denied as well. A couple of huge opportunities coming in from Pillow Fight. Been denied by the woodwork there, Nob, on the second one. Shot from Stem. Oh, goal.
It's the pinch.
Jeez. Was that a pinch off Schmeevil? 147. It had to be.
It was. It definitely was. Nob was absolutely not saving that.
Oh, my. 147Ks to find the second for Ball Bustin' Booties. They've had a little bit of luck go their way. In the last 30 seconds or so, they've scored two. They looked all out at sea early in the contest. I thought this might have just been settled in two, but they have struck back twice and now hold the lead in this very important game in the context of the entire crew battle.
Yeah, again, they looked really nervous in defense earlier on, like when they were having pressure, just missed touches in front of their own goal. Like a knob, like you say, is just not going to miss out on those.
Schmeevil does want to control the ball here. Takes it out wide. Gets a little bump from Stem, I think, to send him away from the play. Chubby's going to wait down. He's got the corner boost. Plenty left. Gets a 50. Nob is going to be there. He's going to try and dunk him here, Schmeevil. Nob does well to cut it. Can Stem affect the save here? He's going to be 2v1 for a little while before Chubby gets back. Needs another save. It's off the crossbar. And again, Pillow Fighter denied by the woodwork, and they are both ahead of this play. This is going to be the third for Ball Bustin' Booties, and they have turned this around, Breezy.
Yeah, a few mistakes, I think, come out then from Pillow.
Pillow Fight, yeah,
there's some Pillow Talk there. My brain was trying desperately to say Pillow Talk, and I'm like, no, that's not what we're going for here. I think they've made a few mistakes here in the early part, the latter stage of this game just now. They had was it Stem in a 2v1 and just didn't capitalize.
Yeah, and it could turn into a goal immediately afterwards as well. It's a disappointing play from the two of them. Stem looking for a ground pinch there, misses out, going to have to rotate through some pads. Mid boost is gone. Chubsy's giving the ball to Nob. I'm not sure what Nob's got in mind. I thought he might have been going for an edge ball there. That was going to be very exciting if he did. He's just punching it onto the back wall. Big chance for Schmeevil. Does really well there, Schmeevil. Both players were awkwardly positioned for the save. Slowed it down, waited for Chubsy to actually jump off the wall before firing. Closes the gap.
Well, definitely keeping them within reach and keeping the one eye on the win on this game.
Maybe with an edge of... Oh, it's denied by the woodwork again!
They left it so late to charge.
Pass inboard. Stem's not going to go for that, surely. Nob is there. Nob wanted the boost. Nobody got the boost. Nob just pushes that ball away. A little bit of miscommunication coming in from Schmeevil and Nob here. Oh, Schmeevil jumps, gets the 50 with Chubsy. It ends up in the corner. This is a very nervous looking few moments here. This game in game number one opened up so free flowing and fast. It looks like they've choked up a little bit. What a shot. Like you say, Breezy. Outstanding finish from Chubsy, and he has settled into the contest. We talked about him during the interim after game number one. That is what you want to see from Chubsy. Outstanding.
Yeah, I reckon any closer to Schmeevil, and he was definitely in with a shelter saving it.
Great kickoff from Chubsy as well. Nob's going to have to send this one wide. Chubsy's going to take his boost. Nob with a good second touch, though. He will be completely dry here. Sends it middle. Schmeevil's going to have to wait down. He's going to be 2v1 here. He does well to flick the ball away. Nob recovering on none. That corner boost is there for him, though. But the big problem here. Oh, boy. This hasn't been their game, Breezy. It really hasn't. They haven't actually played that poorly. They've made some mistakes we have picked at the mistakes they've made, but they have been denied by the post and crossbar so many times in this game, and then things like that as well. Not going their way.
Rotation. All Nob had to do was slam that into the ground, and it would have been really awkward for Stem, I think, who was waiting outboard to try and shoot it.
This would be the sixth coming in for Ball Bustin' Booties. What was the score in game number one? I think it was 4-2 from memory, so another 3-1 maybe.
I think, yeah, or maybe 5-3, potentially, something like that.
It's been a big turnaround from Ball Bustin' Booties, and Pillow Fight are certainly the ones that are going to need to find something come game number three. I think all life has been taken from this particular match. We're going to go to the third, and it's difficult to bet against Ball Bustin' Booties after this performance. I really liked what we saw from Pillow Fight in game number one. but all Bustin Booties have looked very, very good in game number two. And they will be my favourites heading into game number three. Great save from Nob to deny us another kickoff.
It will, but I will absolutely not count out Pillow Fight as well. Like you say, if they decide to have a poor game next game, they will drop it. So they've really got to be on form.
What do we reckon, chat? Who is winning game number three? It's the second game three of the crew battle so far. It has been a tight, tight contest. And I imagine the threes will be something similar as well. That's going to be another fast and exciting contest between these two teams. Ready up. Schmeevil and Nob, neither of those two have readied up yet. Reflecting on the game that was, or maybe the game that is to be. If they win it, the crew battle is theirs. If they lose it, they will have to reload in the threes and start from scratch. As an ass man, I have to give it to the Booties. Can we try a new server? Yes, we can.
Cool.
Minbu. That's close. That'll do. It's interesting. We don't usually get the shout-outs for the bad servers. You see it a lot in kind of like international pro Rocket League. You see people calling for the new servers and whatever, but we don't see it a lot around here.
You get it. You get the odd. You get the odd though international match, don't you? Opposite servers.
Yeah, that's true.
Especially in the ones tournament that that has been run recently.
Yeah, all those Saudi Arabian players trying to play on the EU servers, still dominating. If they're the ones you're talking about, Bruzy.
Correct. This is it for all the marbles.
Here we go, game number three. First goal, important. I always say it in a game number three. But this is such a tight contest. Dangerous ball in, dangerous challenge from Stem as well. Nob's not going to get around it. He picked the wrong moment to jump. He was never going to find the angle.
Those challenges from Stem, they're letting him down a little bit. He's going for balls that he really shouldn't be.
Stem. Somewhat of a veteran these days. He's only played in one series of crew battles, but they went a very long way last chapter.
Oh, what a pinch.
It was a great pinch. Getting chased is Schmeevil by Chubbsy. Stem waits back, ends up in a really awkward position as a result. Nob's going to score. When the ball went through the gap there, I felt like Stem should have been there to challenge. Stem was back. Great flick from Schmeevil. Gets an immediate flick off the crossbar and down, and Nob is there to finish. Pillow fight again. Open the scoring.
This time from Stan.
Schmeevil on the back wall to take it away though. Gonna see a challenge here from Chubbsy, low on boost. He's gonna have to try and find some. Stem with all the responsibility and defense now. Schmeevil with the dunk. Nob goes up with low boost. It's a good first touch, but he's got nothing to chase it with. Stem will clear it out wide. What are you laughing at?
I just love to see it. Never again. But he actually got a perfect first touch for a double setup if he did have boost to get that.
Sometimes he's actually super capable. It's really weird. I play so much twos with him, and sometimes he just absolutely pulls it out of his ass. But then sometimes he really doesn't. Stem, Schmeevil, meet in the forward half. Four ball Bustin Booties, but nothing comes of it. It falls to Stem, who just slams it downfield, looking to cause some chaos in defense. Oh, good shot from Chubbsy, but well denied by Schmeevil. It was a good setup in the end between the two players. Well denied by Pillow Fight. Chubbsy this time in defense. Nob just keeping the pressure on here. He's low on boost though. Stem and Chubbsy both on this side of the field. Shot comes in from Stem. The Nob was back anyway. See what he was thinking. Miss comes in from Chubbsy. Shot comes in from Stem. Shot comes in from Chubbsy, but it's denied by Nob. Nob will take the boost. Stem off the play. It's going to be a 2v1 for the moment. That's a poor touch from Nob. It's going to be easy for Stem to clear that out. Chubbsy and Stem both ahead of the play. Stem can't affect a good touch. Where is Chubbsy? You see both players committing to the corner here for Pillow Fight. Chubbsy sending the ball middle. Stem will collect this. Surely good challenge from Nob. It's going to be a goal to Schmeevil. Is it in? It's wide. No, it's in. And they find their second.
Yeah, just a few overextensions and they've been punished there. Like again, at that 2v1 scenario.
Yeah, Bustin Booties really held the advantage on that play for a long time. But they've been caught out again on the counter-attack. Shot comes in from Chubbsy, but it's a poor one. They're not really manufacturing anything at the moment here, Bull Bustin Booties. They're just hitting in hope a lot of the time. They're going to need to start manufacturing something. Schmeevil and Knob are too good to be caught out. Otherwise...
Trying to beat Knob at a war of attrition as well is such a fucking tough ask.
You're right, Stem and Schmeevil. Here comes Chubbsy down the line. He's got Knob in the way. Sends it middle. Stem can't commit to it. Knob's going to take the mid boost. And the ball. Even 50, but it's still pillow fight. The first one's there. There's only 2 minutes of Rocket League left. We've seen nothing on the board from Ball Bust and Booties. They scored 6 goals in game number 2. They're yet to find the back of the net here. Good boost grab. Stem doesn't go. Is Stem got no boost? I'm not sure what's going on here. Stem stays back.
I don't think he has much.
Chubbsy. Good touch from Chubbsy. Denies Knob. Chance here for Chubbsy. Can he get it in? He can! Schmeevil takes the long way around and Chubbsy sees the opportunity and finds the bottom corner. Knob with the wave dash fail in recovery. Leaves Schmeevil all out at sea in defense. And they strike back. Breezy, will they find another?
I think they have to. The pressure is on them now, but... as we've said throughout some of these games, they've not enjoyed pressure being on them.
Chubbsy with the touch out, but you see Schmeevil and Knob, they're positioned so aggressively, and they've been denied by the crossbar again. That's hit the roof for Chubbsy. He didn't get the flip in the end. Stem's going to have to follow this one back into his corner. Looking for a 50 here. Holds onto the flip for the longest time, and has been eliminated from the play. Schmeevil and Knob. Now raffling it in defense. Schmeevil decides to take it. Knob jumps as well. There they go. Should be Chubbsy's ball in defense. Slams it downfield. If you had it on target, it would have been a goal. Another chance opens. He's missed it out wide, though. Faked out a little bit by the challenging defender. 43 seconds remaining. One goal still separating the teams. Stem tries to pass it inboard. Schmeevil is the first one there. Stem managed to recover in time. Schmeevil there. Down only as far as Stem. Chubbsy looking for some mech. That ball is high. Can he get the ball around and on target? The flip reset off the crossbar. Where is Stem? There he is, and he's equalized. Outstanding from Chubbo. The confidence heading into one of the final plays of regulation time. They were a goal down, and they have equalized in style. 2 apiece, Breezy. 2 apiece.
Exactly the danger that said Chubbo brings to the table earlier on, and we didn't really get a chance to see it for him until it was at its most crucial.
There will be nervous players on the field now. We look like we are heading to OT to decide the result of the twos. It stays up, it's probably not in their favour, and Stem lands it. Who's going to win, Breezy? Pick a team.
Ball Busters,
and we're going to the threes, according to Breezy. It's not the best jump from Nobbo. Chubbsy manages to sort of spin out there on the challenge, though. Stem asks a lot of himself to try and intercept that on the wall in an effective way. Sends it middle, but it's going to go straight to Knob. Chubbsy will need to save this. He's not going to.
A Knob downfield snipe.
Stem. Slammed the ball middle, didn't he? Right onto the nose of Knob.
Not like this.
Chubbsy just went for the side.
Not like this.
As it happened.
It was the perfect shot in the end from Knob. He slammed it downfield. It was an absolute snipe and did not allow any time for Chubbsy to reach that corner boost. The threes will continue. Chubbsy, I think, is gone, but he will be required. Is Chubbsy... Chubbsy is no longer in Rocket League? No one can beat the Knob, yes. It is a bit that way. We will still play the three... he's had some lag. Okay, gotcha.
All good.
Yeah, unfortunate for the Ball Bust and Booties. They have played so well for nothing so far. 2 series in favor of Pillow Fight.
You have my attention. Stop posting links. Wow, Jesus. Ooh, you Remy. Are being watched.
Yeah, boy. GG's. Have we got everyone back in? I'm not sure whether we got a Chubsy back. Did he join the party again?
Yes, I believe he did. Yes, he's back here.
He did. Hopefully
his spy game is laggy.
Back in time. We are heading to the threes regardless for seeding purposes. It's been such a good contest. It's such a shame almost, not for, obviously not for pillow fight players, but for the general, it is such a shame that this has ended with pillow fight taking the twos and the ones, because I feel like this three series will also be super entertaining.
Yeah, for sure. I think it'll still be absolutely a tight contest. They'll still want to get time on the field with each other for the threes.
I have no idea who will win this particular contest.
Prize
either.
A mod. He's not a mod.
I think it looks like, I think Cry and Remy are the only ones in the... Oh, Cry is a
Cry's
mod.
Cry's a mod.
Cry is a mod. Were you a mod earlier in that? I'm sure I looked at Cry's name earlier and he wasn't a mod. One of the only ones. Are mods making each other mods now? Is that what's happening?
They gain sentience.
Oh, bang! Oh, Chubsy scores Chubsy. The first. Let's all be mods. Poor Remy on his lonesome, not a mod.
Would you like a good pass from Pepsi, though. Really good in board.
Oh, Solstice is here as well. There you go. Two non-mods in the crowd of mods.
I'm surprised. I think the only mods in my channel, I think, are the actual admin team. I think that's it.
It's handy to have a lot of people around for predictions and that sort of stuff.
True.
Yeah, can't hurt. The prediction can end, actually. Do you know what a WDT tool is for coffee? I stabbed myself in the end of the thumb with one. I think I do. Are you talking about the... It looks like a... Like a very agricultural tool with a bunch of needles hanging out of it that stirs up the coffee grinds before you tamp it. Is that what you're talking about, Dan? That's the one. That's the one, yes sir. Yeah, I can imagine how someone could hurt themselves with that. Yeah, makes sense. Oh, it's been denied by Step, has it? No, wait, Schmeeble does get back.
Focus it was nearly on the game. In. It was nearly a next level play. But they've come out swinging now, the ball bustings.
Yeah, they have. I don't know what... oh, that's a goal coming in from Nob there. Both two misses on the goal line there from Ball Bust and Booties. What is Chubbo's native game mode, Breezy? You have played a little bit with him. Is he a threes player?
I think he's a twos main, primarily. But I think he has played one... he's played at one series against me. He asked me to play him in ones before crew battles just to warm up before he goes and plays twos. And I think he has experience in all three game modes, I want to say. But I would say he's primarily a twos player.
Okay. Likes a bit of space for his mech, perhaps?
Yes, correct. I think he very much likes his demos, likes his follow-through demos, and likes to perform his mech whenever he gets the chance. We see him here now from the ball to the backboard.
C3 and 1s is really good. See, the ranking system in 1s is the most broken thing in Rocket League, other than the ranking system in Rumble, which is arguably more broken. There are some extremely good players ranked criminally low in ones.
It's just hard to get out of that, out of those ranks. I think someone yesterday was talking to me about really struggling getting out of C2. I think it was Mayo said he was struggling to get out of C2 in ones.
Do you think there's excuse me? Do you think there's a lot of smurfs? So what is it that's actually making it tough? I can't get out of C1 myself, but that's just because I'm actual trash at the game. Nothing else to blame other than that.
Yeah, I think potential smurfs, but also I think like people just like that grind in ones can be a little bit like you need you'd be surprised how much extra you need about you in OCE to get up the ranks, like a little something extra in the locker.
Pepsi gets a good shot away there. Well done by Chubsy. Oh, Stem and Chubsy combine again. Pepsi slammed one on target there. It was well met in the end. I think it was Schmeevil that got in the way. But a lovely follow-up from Chubsy. Ball Bust and Booties are looking really good in the threes here. seeding is important. It's actually more important in this particular event than it has been ever before, I think, because you can find yourself in a really poor position. If you end up in that 1 or 0-2 group, you could find yourself in a real poor position, or even a poor seeding in the 1-1 group, and having to play that funny little pink game that nobody understands in the bracket. Things could become very awkward very quick.
Yeah, you'll get an unfavorable matchup if you so it is important to try your best. Even if you've lost the crew battle by the third game mode, it is important to try and win as many game modes as you can.
This could be one of those crew battles as well. When we were doing the seedings last chapter, I found that there was actually a lot of crew battles that finished 4 games apiece between the teams. And this could be one of those, considering that Ball Bust and Booties did take a game in each of the series they lost, and they could win this one 2-0. Would mean 4 games apiece between the two teams. It's heartbreaking, but it does happen quite frequently.
Yeah, for sure. This is looking a little stronger though for the Ballbusting Booties.
Schmeeble's also
turned up here.
Schmeeble's also another one I don't really know much about. I don't know what his native game modes are. I'm really impressed with what we've seen from Schmeeble so far in this particular contest, though.
Well, I've only seen him playing with Nob as of last night, I believe. Be getting some work in, getting some reps in.
Nah, it's good to hear. There's been so many teams that have been scrimming and practicing and all that sort of stuff, more than we've ever seen before in this particular chapter of Crewbells. It's really good to see. And those teams that are playing together are getting good results as well. It makes a huge difference.
It'd be good to see it continue throughout as well. Just like, you know, to get time together. Really get to know your teammates, the strengths, the weaknesses. Like figure out a way to play with one another. I think it helps your game as well. Like you can figure out how to play with people you're not familiar with.
Yeah, absolutely. Even once a week, that would surely be enough. At least get the feet wet with the team. Went in completely cold with the team yesterday, I think it was, wasn't it? And we did pay the price in the end. I played rather terribly, but that is expected.
It says winning the bombs 2-0.
Yeah, I don't know if you were watching the threes. I kind of hope you weren't, but
no, I was casting with Choco.
Yeah, we don't talk about that. No longer casual tourney. It's sweatier than my 1900 casual games. Yes, it is getting a little bit that way, but it's good to see that even though the competition is firing up, we still see really good community spirit. Chubsy is still having internet issues there. I actually haven't looked at the scoreboard the entire series during gameplay, but there you see Chubsy's issue. I doubt it's a server issue in particular. It looks like a more of a Chubsy issue.
Might be maybe marginalized though by the 3v3 game mode. Obviously, definitely probably would play more of a factor the less players on the field.
Yep. Rizza bullied me. Yeah, I'm sorry, Fighter. Look. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to follow that with. I'm sorry, Fighter. Sorry I had to be that way.
I saw it and I was like, I wonder who agreed to this.
It wasn't me.
No offense.
It wasn't me.
No offense to the great man you are, Fighter. Riz does have, as much as he plays himself down, which is utter BS, but anyway, carrying on. He does also have a lot of experience in the Ones Arena. He's keen to 1v1 people from time to time.
Yeah, look, honestly, I was trying to get Epic to play Binker in the Ones. I thought that would have been the better matchup all around, and then it would have been Fighter and Merz versus myself and Blast in the Twos. Thought that would have been a pretty well-rounded matchup, but didn't gain any traction in the end, and it ended up being what it was, which is whatever.
Let's see, wedding down, looking very uncomfortable with that ball off her backboard. In the business though, here.
How did Schmeeble get a Devo there? It takes out Chubsy in the end, wasn't really moving.
I think he flipped into it. He tried to flip. I think he honestly tried to wave dash onto the wall and ended up getting the demo instead.
Quick Flow looking to catch this one in defense. All three players from Pillow Fighter there. Good touch out from Quick Flow as well into Schmeeble. Schmeeble with another one. And another one. And then Nob's there. Nob misses out. All the heavy lifting.
A three-person play.
It was. All the heavy lifting was done from his teammates beforehand. All he needed to do was jump into the ball. Couldn't quite make it happen. Here comes Nob to make up for his mistake. He hits it softly into Bepsy, who puts it out wide. Actually, even with a nice first touch over the top of Bepsy as well. Stem waits back, clears it out. Very much a sweeper is Bepsy. Stem. Last crew battles we saw it a lot as well. Very defensively minded player. Oh, bang goes Nob. He's caught them out before in that fashion, but Stem is there. If you remember back to game 3 OT, the big bangs coming in from Nob were the difference. Here comes Quick Flow, misses out.
Definitely. Again, that was what surprised me the most about the twos is the seeing those. Again, it may have been just down to nerves. Seeing some of those challenges where you think to yourself, you know, you could just see straight away he was like, he's never winning this ball.
Chubsy completely empty. Pepsi Cola goes flying past it. Stem takes a wild shot, but it's wide. Well, swept out by Nob anyway. Here comes Chubsy again, low on boost. Ends up flipping upside down to hit the ball. Ends up recovering really poorly as a result. Down the line there from Beps. Tries to take out Nobbo, who clears the path for himself. There is Stem. Gets a nice 50 and another one as well. Can't quite bring it around. Nothing separating the teams through the first couple of minutes here. It was all Bill, Bust and Booties at this stage in game number one. Are we going to see?
Definitely had the majority again, though. No?
We're going to see a little resurgence from Pillow Fight here in game number two. Touch coming in from Quickfoe, looks to follow it up, but can't make any effect on the play. Chubsy.
B-bone.
Can't continue on zero boost. Pepsi going to follow this one around. Stem rotates out. Quickfoe going to challenge Pepsi. Thinking back to that 1v1 as well, that was another outstanding contest. We've been talking a bit about the twos. The ones was also very entertaining from start to finish between Pepsi and Quickfoe. What a save from Peps. Off the inside of the post and out. And here comes Beps again.
Nobbo as well.
Another chance here. Here comes Chubsy, and that is a Bepsy special. She takes it all the way from defense. Makes the save off the inside of her post. Clears the ball downfield over all three. Sends it into the back wall, and Chubsy says, thank you very much. And Ball, Bustin, Booties find the first of game number two. And continue on where they left off in game number one. Stem with a pre-flip into position, looking for the flip reset. Can't quite, but fakes out. Quick flow. Nob clears it out over the top of Bepsy. Chubsy, last man, sends it right back in, off the crossbar and out. Schmeevil touches it out wide off of that crossbar. There is Nob. He is going to try and collect this one off the side. What a touch from Nob. What is that nonsense? As he sends it downfield on target from nowhere.
Chubsy looked like he was just absolutely stunned. Flashbanging goal.
Just full brakes applied. What is going on here? This guy has the cheat codes on. Quick flow.
He's stationary for a good few seconds.
Touches it out wide. Gets it over the top of Chubsy as well. Does well, but it's wide. Pillow Fight will need to score. There's 50 seconds remaining or they will lose the threes. They have taken the series, though, in the ones and the twos. Quickflow looking to put this one middle. It's on Schmeevil, and it's in. They find a way through. It's not been easy for them. Ball Bust and Booties have been very, very good in the threes so far. But Pillow Fight claw their way back into this contest.
One missed touch by Chubsy, and that was enough to open the gate for them.
Demento, there is a... I think there is, anyway. There might not be. I think there is a Choose My Raid redemption that you can claim if you would like to pick someone in particular.
Yeah, apologies. The intention is to raid people. I think it just kind of got overlooked for the first 2 weeks. I think we were so busy. Like, I had one eye on the Discord, and like other things were happening. So I think I just forgot to do it. But I will aim to raid people in future games. That is absolutely fine.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. Sometimes it is actually quite an exhausting exercise getting the whole thing together just to stream one match. And sometimes when it's all over, it's just nice to go and put your feet up for a minute. It's that last little step we forget sometimes. But yeah, we do have that. I would, but I lost all my eggplants. Well, then that is unfortunate. Maybe you can reach out to somebody else. I'm not trying to be difficult, Demento. I just want all the tackle I possibly can get out of the community. Out of the community. Yeah, oh, Stem's going to score. Yes, he does.
Oh, what a goal. Nice. Good from Stem.
Picks up and delivers. It looks likely to be a goal from the very first jump. Outstanding precision from Stem. And that just is over. GG's. And like we talked about, Breezy, that is what it looks like. A 4-4 game overall.